our midst. So I'm not going to talk about Sunday of Orthodoxy, really. That we'll have that in the Vespers tonight. So what good can come from Nazareth? It's kind of like saying, what good can come from Millet? Or it's a place called Harry Hills, too. You know, Nazareth was just, you know, backwater town, nothing exciting, nothing big. And then we see, come and see. So with Nazareth, what could, let's look at this in a spiritual way. What good can come from my heart, my Nazareth, right? And then we hear, come and see. And we know that, you know, it was said to Nathaniel, come and see. Come and see the Lord. And as we are invited to come and see. Come and see the Lord. And, you know, the beginnings of, we made it through the first week of Great Lent. A lot of Advil might have been used. As we are cleaning ourselves, we're asked again to come and see. Let's bring our Nazareth, our heart out. Bring it to the Lord. And, you know, I know I spoke about this, I think, last Tuesday, but to come to see the Lord, we struggle. Some of you might have heard this, but too bad. Saying it again, because I'm the boss. We struggle to come and see the Lord. We struggle to open our hearts to the Lord. And we really see that with the hymnography of the canons last week. And we co-struggle with each other. This is just not a one-time thing. You know, it's not just me, I'm struggling with myself. We struggle with each other. Because we are brothers and sisters, right? And most of the time, brothers and sisters struggle with each other and help each other. There's that percentage of fights. Just the same. One of six kids. And as we struggle, we increase our faith. Yes, I believe in Lord Jesus Christ. Anyone can say that. But it's our faith and our struggling that we get to know our Lord and God, Savior Jesus Christ. But it's the struggle to come and see. And we do it on, you know, it's an everyday thing that we do. And then we come together as a community to struggle with each other, to be with each other, to listen to each other. And at that time, we're struggling still. So, to come out with faithfulness to the Lord is action. To come and see is walking towards. Yes, we trip on the way. We all trip. But usually when we fall, we always fall forward. So we're still falling forward to the Lord. And as we are going through Great Lent, yes, the services are a little longer. Yes, you know, there's more time that for contemplation. We don't eat meat or anything to calm our bellies down, to calm ourselves down, so we can hear, so we can be Nathaniel and be amazed that Christ just had to say to him, I saw you under the fig tree, and he believed and was faithful at that moment. That is not so much. It takes a little bit more work for us. Because we're pretty thick-headed. I'm pretty thick-headed. And it's the fights, it's the cleansing, it's the working towards Christ, come and see, you know, for us, the risen Lord, making ourselves worthy to participate in the Lord, to participate fully in Holy Communion. And I know I've heard a lot, you know, I have to have confession before, and I keep talking about this, so just do it as a, anyway. You know, I can't have communion without confession. Well, that's wrong. We need the food, especially right now. We need the food of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ. That's why we have pre-sanctified liturgy in the middle of the week. We know the struggle. We're trying to come see Him and participate in His death and resurrection. Why would we starve ourselves? Yeah, kind of makes sense. We need the energy to fight the good fight, to keep the course of the fast. If we don't have that, I don't know. Makes it more difficult to come and see. And I realize and understand there's catechumens and inquirers. You know, you can't participate in Holy Communion yet. But that's why you come to church and you be around people, especially with the catechumens and inquirers. They need our prayers more because they are not participating or they can't participate in Holy Communion. We need to struggle with them, especially with a lot of people. This is your first Great Lent. And, you know, you will have thoughts that you didn't have thoughts about, you know, for like 10 years. Well, welcome to Great Lent. The evil one is very active during this time. And that's why we need to pray for the catechumens and choirs, struggle with them, talk with them, say, you know, how I got through. For the rest of us, how can we do that if we don't have Holy Communion? Or really participating to come and see Christ. So as we move forward for the Great Lent, just remember, good can come out of our hearts every single day. We may not realize it, may not understand it, but good can come out of our hearts so we can come and see the Lord. In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, amen. Christ is in our midst. Amen.